Well, hello and welcome along to this little tutorial about how to get started fast with Camunda and Spring Boot. You would never have guessed that by the title, but that's what we're going to talk about right now. And if you're wondering who I am, my name is, of course, Niall Deaton. I'm a developer advocate for Camunda. Generally speaking, I try to help everybody get started with ease with the open source version of Camunda's platform. I'm also, of course, joined as always by Faf de Klerk, my faithful companion and Harris Hawk. Okay, so what are we doing specifically? Well, we're going to be using an IDE of some kind. I'm using IntelliJ to essentially create a Spring Boot project in a very easy way and start it up. So if you don't already have one, go ahead and download it there. You can also use Eclipse. It doesn't really matter, even NetBeans if you like. We also, of course, require a certain amount of internet access. If you don't have that, well, first of all, well done for getting your hands in this video. But also, I really don't know how to help you on that one. You're going to need to phone someone who has far more power than me. Finally, if you want to download the Camunda modeler, that's also going to be very useful. You'll be able to find that at the website at camunda.com/download/modeler and just get the latest version to that suits your operating system. Once you have that, we can actually then get started. So let's do that. So we're actually going to start here just to show you guys what currently exists with regard to getting started with Spring Boot. We do have a getting started guide here on docs.camunda.org. You can find it right here. And what this actually talks about is the project setup, the different things you need to add. For instance, you, people who already know Spring Boot, you need to add some dependencies for Camunda and Spring Boot. You need to make sure the REST API works and a whole bunch of other things and create a class and blah, 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 and loads of reading. Okay, let's not do that. Luckily, a colleague of mine has decided to make this a lot easier. So Tassilo has created this wonderful little place called start.camunda.com. If you go there, you're going to come across this lovely page here. So this page lets you generate a Spring Boot project with the Camunda dependencies in a much easier way. So you see here that we have a group name for our project, and we have a project name. So this is going to be something like, let's say, WC for Ireland. Those who know that the Rugby World Cup has started will know that obviously Ireland will very likely win this. So as I record this, this is far from accurate at the moment. Next, we'll actually decide to use which Camunda version we want to choose. This is important because very often there's an issue where if you choose a version of Camunda, like I'll go, for instance, with 7.11, you need a corresponding Spring Boot version to use with that. They are actually version dependencies. And this little site decides to actually give you that automatically, so you don't need to tinker with that. It's a really common problem. Next up, you can actually choose the kind of database you have. So H2 is the default one because it's very easy to get started. But if you actually want to use Postgres or MySQL, then a Docker file will be created so that you can start those guys up and connect to it in a more sort of a close to production way. So I'm going to use H2 in this case. And next up, my Java version, I'm going to select 11. And now here's the fun part. This is the bit where people kind of get a bit mixed up sometimes. The Camunda modules that we actually need to add would be the REST API and also the web apps themselves. That would be cockpit and task list. I'll go through those shortly. You can also, of course, choose to include some Spring Boot modules as well, like Spring Security and web. So the next thing, of course, is we need an admin username and password. This is actually for how to access cockpit and task list. So this would be demo would be what I'll create. And once you actually have that up and running, you can click on this little explore project to see what actually gets created. And you can see the POM file here shows all the stuff that in the documentation is already explained. So you see with the Spring Boot starter there, there's the REST, there's the web apps, and so on and so forth, the H2 database I selected. But also the YAML file has the admin user for Camunda as well. And of course, we also have the application class that needs to be there. Okay, so next it just requires us to click on generate project, and this will actually just let us download a nice little zip file with the Rugby World Cup for Ireland. And now it's up to us to go in and import this file into our IDE, which we'll do next. Alrighty, so we have our Rugby World Cup Ireland zip file right here, so let's go ahead and unzip this. Great. Now what we're actually creating here is a folder with all of the code and projects that we saw earlier on the start.camunda.com website. And I'm just going to copy the location of this, and then I'm going to go to IntelliJ, where I'm going to click on open. Now I'm just need to pop in the location, and there it is, it's finding the POM file, and we should then be creating a little project. Ooh, that's a fun tip. Thanks, IntelliJ. Okay, so now it's going to build the project. And in a few seconds, we should be able to see our project in full flow. There it is. And if I open it up, it has all the stuff that we've come to know and love. We have here the application class we created. We also have great stuff. We also have in resources the application YAML. And the POM file is populated with all the things we added as well. So if we wanted to, we can actually start this right away. So I'm just going to quickly open up this Maven thing. I'm just going to do a Maven install to make sure that we have all the dependencies. Alrighty, so the build has been successful, and now we can actually see that we have a target folder. But right now we're just going to right click on application, and I'm just going to run the application. Okay, so it looks like Camunda is up and running. So if I then go to Opera and say localhost 8080, here we are greeted with the Camunda web apps, which we added. We know the username and password, which is demo. And now here we are in cockpit and task list and admin. So we can go in, for instance, and check out what's going on in cockpit. Not too much, I suspect. Nothing is running right now, which means the next step is simply to create a process. We have Camunda up and running, so now let's actually get ourselves a process deployed. So that's next. And to make that process deployable, we of course need the Camunda modeler. Now, if you haven't already found that, just go to camunda.com/download and you should be greeted right here by this little tab for modeler on the far left, and then choose your operating system. Now, I've already done this, so let's open it up, and we're going to be creating a BPMN diagram. It's pretty straightforward. We are going to give it a name, which is Win World Cup. Great stuff. And I will give it a name as well, called Win World Cup. So we have a strategy, of course, which is Ireland enters World Cup as world number one, some may be asking about. And then we need to beat all teams. Let's have this as a user task, because it does require a certain amount of physical activity. And then Ireland wins. Great. So we have our path to success, and now we need to put it where it belongs. Specifically, we need to go back to our project, and we need to put it here in the resources folder so it gets picked up. So I'm just going to copy the path. I'm going to go back here. I'm just going to save it. I'm going to save it right here as Win Rugby World Cup. Great. And now we can see that it is showing up right here. Fantastic. And now I'm just going to stop this current Wi-Fi distro. As you can see, right now we should have in cockpit nothing yet deployed. There's no definitions. So I'm just going to stop this, and I'm going to start it back up in the same way we did before. When I start it up, it's going to pick up the BPMN model in the resources folder, and it's then going to deploy it to the engine on startup. And then, so now if we were to go back and refresh that page, let's take a look. After I log in again, I assume. Yeah, cockpit, great, demo. And we have one process definition, fantastic. If I click on it, Win World Cup. And there we have our strategy. Next up, what I can do is I can start the instance, of course. To do that, I'm going to go to a different tool. I'm going to go to task list. So I'm going to go here to task list. Now in task list, you'll see that we have no filter. So you can click on this little button right here. This is going to filter user tasks for us. So if I click on that, it automatically creates an all tasks filter. Great, so now we're prepared to take on the challenge. And then next up, I'm going to click on Start Process. I'm going to select Win World Cup and then click Start here. So now we have our task has appeared. Beat all teams. I haven't created UI for it, so it looks like this. We can see where we are here as a user. And if I go back to cockpit, I should be able to refresh this page and see that, oh, there we go. We are waiting to beat all the teams. Now, I dare not complete this task at the moment because the Rugby World Cup is still going on. But hopefully, by the time that you read this, we would have already won, and this will make so much more sense. Hope this has helped you get started. Please let us know on the forum if you have any questions. To go there, just go to forum.camunda.org, where you can ask questions here, and you'll likely get answers. So thank you. Bye-bye.